I'm Ken Priddy with the GO Center. When we're dealing with the revitalization of a church, one of the leading issues is the issue of authority. Where does authority lie? Now, the natural response is to think that this is a governance question, and authority lies with the pastoral staff or the elders of the church. And that's certainly true in a sense. But there's a higher authority, a vertical authority, and that authority is God Himself. Now, that's not a surprise theologically, as this is, of course, the Church of Jesus Christ that we're talking about, and Jesus is preeminent. He's the head of the church. But the way that Jesus is represented in revitalization has to do with His vision for the church. What is God the Father's vision? What is God the Son's vision? What is God the Spirit's vision for the church? Well, in very shorthand terms, I want to suggest to you that the vision of God for His church is the Great Commission. And the Great Commission begins with Jesus speaking of authority. He says, "All authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples." Well, where did this authority that comes to Jesus come from? It comes from God the Father. It comes to God the Son. Jesus is on a mission to seek and save the lost. He was commissioned by His Father to be on this search and rescue mission. And then He turns to His disciples and He co-missions them. That's why we call this passage the Great Co-Mission. So the place that we want to start in the discussion of authority is at the very top with vision. And we're talking about a very particular kind of vision. We're talking about a Great Commission vision. God has a vision of a church that goes in the authority of Christ to make disciples, to baptize, to teach obedience to the things that Jesus commanded. And there's the promise of Christ that He will be with them, with us, to the very end of the age. So you see, this authority is being passed from God the Father to God the Son, and ultimately to us through God the Spirit. So we're talking about a very particular kind of vision, what I like to call a rightly discerned godly vision. Now, with that vision understood and in place, we are going to support that vision with strategy. A strategy answers the question, how? If we look at vision, the question is what? What are we going to accomplish? And also, why? Why is that what we're going to accomplish? Well, the what is that we're going to go and make disciples. And why are we going to do that? Because Jesus commanded us to go and make disciples. It's really that simple. Now, with strategy, we come to the question, how are we going to go and make disciples? What is going to look like in the context of our church serving in our community? Now, the next step down is structure. Now, structure includes those infrastructure pieces of ministry, such as our staff, our budget, our finances, other leaders, lay leaders, as well as professional leaders. It includes our organizational chart, our committees, our policies and procedures, the building, all of the things that go into supporting ministry. Well, strategy answers the question, how are we going to go and fulfill this vision? Structure answers the question, how are we going to resource our strategies? Now, when we have vision, strategy, and structure in proper alignment, we find that we have a church that is on the incline. Now, if you don't know what I'm referring to with this concept of incline, you need to take a look at our video on church life cycle, and that will be explained. Vision, strategy, and structure in proper alignment causes our church to be on the incline. Now, the danger is that this actually works. And when you have these in proper alignment, you have a church that is aggressively, proactively ministering out in the neighborhood, and you have newcomers coming in. Now, as newcomers come into the church, find Christ, become church members and participants, the congregation grows. Now, that's a good thing, but there is a challenge. The challenge is that as the congregation grows, what I call the in-reach voice of the church gets louder and louder. Why? Because there are more people on the inside of the church that need to be taken care of. These are the people that we see week after week. These are the people we know by name. We know their families. We know their children. These are the people that serve. These are the people that lead. They're the people that support the church financially. So more and more and more of our attention is turned inward, to the point that our vision of going and making disciples begins to fade. Now, eventually, if this goes unchecked, this godly vision of going and making disciples will fade away. Well, at this point, it's no longer vision supported by strategy, supported by structure. It's strategy supported by structure. But there's a disconnect. You see, strategy is no longer connected to vision. Therefore, strategy is no longer strategic. Strategy has evolved into simply being what I'll call programs. You know, the program activities of the church. Well, at this point, structure redefines itself. It's no longer there to support strategy to fulfill vision. Structure is now in place to support programs. Now, when we have a church that is essentially programs supported by structure, we now have a church that is on the recline. Well, what happens over time? Unless there's some kind of intervention into the life cycle to reorient ministry, we're going to find that we tip to the backside of the life cycle. You see, a program structure church is not going to be capable of sustaining continued growth. And as the attrition rate of people leaving the church is no longer matched by new people coming to the church, we tip to the backside of the life cycle and begin to decline. Now, left unchecked, we'll reach a point on the backside of the life cycle where we can no longer sustain these programs. We don't have the people, we don't have the money, we don't have the time, we don't have the creativity and the talent. And so what will happen is these programs will begin to fade or merge or simply disappear. And finally, we're left with a church that's all structure. Now at this point, structure redefines itself yet again. It's no longer here to support strategy to fulfill vision. It's no longer here even to support programs. Structure is simply here to support itself. When a church is in decline, structure emerges as the leading authority, overshadowing God's vision, overshadowing even the programming, and we're sort of trapped in an organizational nightmare of not being able to move forward because our church is overstructured. Too many policies and procedures, too many committees, too many ways of doing things from the past that are no longer relevant. Nevertheless, we can't change them. Now, here's what often happens. Along comes new vision. It might be in the form of a new pastor that's brought into the scene. It might be that several people in the church have become inspired or convicted in some way, perhaps having attended a seminar or a conference or something of that sort, and they come back with ideas and they realize we've lost the vision that we used to have, and it's time that we get things turned around. Problem, though, is vision, instead of being at the head of authority, is now having to go to structure and ask permission. And typically, structure will say no, because everything about a new vision seems threatening to those that are trapped in a structure-driven church. The church is what I call upside down. Now, the goal of revitalization is to flip the church right side up, restoring God's Great Commission vision as the authoritative element in how ministry unfolds in that particular church. And be very careful. Sometimes the structural component will grant permission to vision, but won't really give it authority. The problem there is that the moment vision begins to rock the balance of things, that permission can be rescinded and we remain stuck upside down. Our goal is to restore vision as the authoritative element of the church. Why? Because it's God's vision. And God's vision is for going and making disciples. And that's what we're going to do as we find who's missing and bring them home.